Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up, I'm going to give you a hands-on tour of your options to deploy Microsoft Edge to hundreds or thousands of devices at scale. We're going to explain the Edge package options for automated installation, how you can deploy Edge to Windows PCs using Microsoft Endpoint Configuration Manager, and ensure that all of your managed devices, including your phones and Macs, can also be provisioned with Edge. The all-new Microsoft Edge is based on Chromium and compatible with both modern web standards, as well as your existing browser-based apps, now through a built-in IE mode that allows you to browse the Internet Explorer-dependent applications and sites that you have without leaving the context of Edge. Now, as you would expect, Edge also brings enterprise-ready security, privacy, and manageability controls, making it the best browser for business across PC, Mac, and mobile devices. And over the next few minutes, we're going to take a look at your deployment options for Microsoft Edge. First, Microsoft Edge offers downloadable packages in a few formats, and there are paths that are built into Configuration Manager and Intune, so you won't need to navigate to download and import packages. That said, if you're using other tools, I'm going to explain your package options. Now, the most common package by far available on the web takes you to microsoft.com/edge, as you see here, where you can download Microsoft Edge Setup.exe. This is a bootstrapper for end users to self-install, either as local administrators or standard users. Now, this package actually determines the best architecture and language configuration automatically, but for a large-scale deployment, it's not the recommended package. So the Windows Installer MSI-based packages can be found at aka.ms/edge-enterprise. Now, here you can get installers for stable, beta, and dev channels, and you'll also use these installation packages with your preferred software distribution tools and methods. But we've made things even easier if you're using Microsoft Endpoint Configuration Manager or Intune, and I'm going to show you the deployment steps for those in a moment. But before I do that, it's worth noting that both stable and beta channels are supported by Microsoft. The stable channel is intended for broad deployment in your organization, and it's the channel that most users should be on. New features will ship about every 6 weeks, while security and quality updates will ship as needed. Now, the beta channel is also intended for production deployment in your organization, but to a smaller representative sample of users. The beta channel is a great way to validate new features and updates before they hit the stable channel. Features and updates follow the same schedule as the stable channel. Now, to learn more about Edge channels, go to aka.ms/edge-channels. Now, let's get back to Microsoft Endpoint Manager and the steps for deploying Edge. First, in Configuration Manager 1910 and newer, Microsoft Edge has an integrated package creation and deployment flow to fetch everything it needs as part of the deployment process, so you won't need to manually import MSI packages. There's a new node that you can see on the left here called Microsoft Edge Management, and we'll click Create Microsoft Edge Application. So to get started, we have to just give it a name. So in my case, I'm just going to call it Edge. Then I have to browse to a location of a folder that's empty, so I'm going to use my server and go to the Edge 2005 folder. Now here I can select the channel that I want. You see stable, dev, and beta. And I can select whether or not I want the latest or a specific version, and I can allow Edge to automatically update with this checkbox that was made available as of 2002 Configuration Manager. I can target the application now to specific machines, but I'll go ahead and click Next, and then I'm done. Now basically what that's going to do in the background is download all of the package components for Edge, and it will be available for you to assign to machines, and you're done. If you've chosen to manage Edge updates, it will also work like anything else that publishes updates via WSUS. Just make sure that you've subscribed to those updates so you can be informed when those updates are available. Now, you saw the dashboard earlier, but I want to point out that this is where you can track Microsoft Edge KPIs, things like installation metrics, versions, usage, and also where it's the default browser. And so those are the top considerations and capabilities for using Configuration Manager, and probably where most people will deploy and manage for Windows. But I'm going to switch gears here and move on to deployment via Intune for both Windows and non-Windows platforms. So Microsoft Edge and Intune is also fully integrated, so you won't need to upload installation packages here either. So we'll start with Windows. So in the All Apps blade, click on Add, and here you would select Windows 10 and then go through the standard process. But in my case, I'm actually going to select macOS as a package. So we'll go ahead and click that and click Select. Then I get the app information pane that we're all used to. We're going to go ahead and click Next and then see the app settings. And now in there, I can also select the channel that I want to deploy. I'm going to stick with stable and click Next, and I can add scope tags if I want to. And here, if I want to assign the different devices I want to deploy to, I can do that. And when I'm done, I click Create and the package is ready for me to deploy. Next, let's take a look at the process for Microsoft Edge mobile apps. It's consistent with the process for adding apps from Apple's App Store as well as Google Play for Android. I'm going to show you in this case, as an example, the process for iOS. So again, in the All Apps blade, we're going to go ahead and click iOS. And when I do that, I'll click Add, and I'll click iOS Store App and Select. Now I'll go ahead and search the App Store for the app. So I'll search for Microsoft Edge. And here we can see the Microsoft Edge app there, and I'll select that. Again, I see app information and all the different fields, the different versions for iOS it's compatible with. I'll click Next. I can click on scope tags and add those here. And I can even assign the different phone devices I want to deploy to. And then I'll see all of the properties here and click Create. And now after some time, those will soon start to appear on your mobile devices if you've targeted some of those for deployment. So that's a quick review of your options to get Microsoft Edge on your managed PCs, Macs, and mobile devices. Of course, that only covers the app deployment process, so keep checking back as we cover the management and policy considerations for Microsoft Edge, as well as how to configure IE mode for Windows. Now you can check out our full playlist for Microsoft Edge and Microsoft Search at aka.ms/edgeforit. Thanks for watching.